Hello, welcome to White Davy Gardening and Worm Farm. If you like my channel, please press the subscribe button. I was out watering the plants this morning and I noticed these two babies underneath here looking quite lovely. So I'm just gonna harvest. So this is my first tomato harvest for the year, my cherry tomatoes. I wasn't sure which type of tomatoes they were because everything in my garden is all mixed up now because of the first set of plants that died. Some of them I didn't have that same particular type to replace, so I ended up putting something else there and I didn't make a record of what it is. I'm very disappointed though to see the amount of apples underneath my apple tree because of the strong winds that we got 2 days ago. But as I was watering the garden, I noticed something else that made me quite happy. So in here, as I was watering, I noticed my first nasturtium bloom. Oh, look at it, isn't it beautiful? Also, I'm going to be harvesting a cucumber from here. Oops. And I'm going to harvest a few strawberries. I don't have a lot of strawberries this time around. Now look at my plants. They look as if they haven't been watered in quite a while, when in fact I did water them this morning. But the heat out here is so bad today. It is super hot. I'm finally rejoicing to see my romaine lettuce, that they are folding, because these plants got eaten down several times. So I only have four of them and the four of them got eaten down to the point where I thought I would not have been able to harvest any. But as you can see, all four of them are folding quite nicely, so I'm very happy for that. Now this heat is really out of control. Look at my pumpkins. They're actually dying from all this heat. Wow, this one is scary looking. I don't even know if that can recover. And as for my corns, I'm not even sure if I'm going to be able to harvest corns from this garden, because with the strong winds that we got, all of the pollens got blown off and the plants haven't even pushed out the corns yet, so there's no silk for it to pollinate. And look at them. With all the water that I gave them, this is how they look. So my garden is struggling under the heat at the moment. And I didn't even plant as many corns as I did last year. So I'm expecting far less corns. And I'm quite disappointed about that. Anyway, I'm going to see if I can rescue some of these apples. Okay, finally, I am seeing sweet peppers on these sweet pepper plants. They're taking forever to grow. They have been flowering for over a month now, and this is the first plant I'm seeing with any peppers on it. You want to see something crazy? Look at this corn. I like the design, the multicolor husk. It's quite beautiful, but look at this. What is this growing out of the corn? I've never seen anything like that before. Have you? This is the first long sweet pepper that I'm harvesting. I don't know if they're naturally green or what color they're going to be when they ripen, because it's the first I'm growing them, and it's the first I'm going to be eating them too. It's quite windy today, and my plants are not happy with all this wind. It keeps blowing things off. I have to be racing with the birds to be able to harvest any of these strawberries. It seems as if this romaine lettuce is getting ready to seed, so I'm going to allow it to remain. I'm just going to harvest the leaves from around it, but I'm not going to disturb the entire plant, because I want to have a lot of romaine lettuce seeds, and you only get a few in the sachet when you buy them at the garden center. So I'm gonna allow this one to seed. My cucumber harvest this year is better than last year. Last year was pretty terrible, don't know why, but anyway, although this year is still not good, but it's a whole lot better than last year. I'm going to be harvesting some apples too, but usually I would shake the tree, but I don't want to do that because it has been so windy. And a lot of the apples are falling off on their own because of the wind. So what I do pretty much is just touch the fruit. I would shake the tree usually, but now I'm just touching the fruit, and if it falls off, then I know it is ready. These ones don't really change color. Yesterday, I harvested a whole plastic bag of them. And then today it's windy, so quite a lot of them are falling off the tree. So I'm just gonna gather the good ones, and then the rest I'm going to be harvesting separately and put those in the bin for my worms. And it seems as if the wasps finally decide to feed on my apples. But thankfully this time around, they took longer than they usually would. So I'm able to harvest, because last year, the apple tree did do well. But the wasp and the bees destroyed the crop so that we weren't able to harvest any last year. So I have some more cherry tomatoes. Look at this. Oh my goodness, that's solid in there. My first okra. I'm gonna be harvesting some callaloo as well. I don't know why, but this time of year, I don't know if it has something to do with the fact that summer is about to end, but for whatever reason, this time of year my callaloos usually slow down in the rate at which they grow, unfortunately. Everything wants to go into seeding. But more than anything else, I'm worried about my sweet potatoes, because the temperature is going to be, they say, the low of 10 and 11 throughout the rest of this week and into next week. And I'm worried because temperatures usually either go a little lower than they say, or a little higher than they say. If it goes lower than what they say, then my sweet potatoes will be in trouble. I hope not. Only going to allow one of my callaloo plant to go into seeding. These ones are getting rather old. They are seriously affected by the seems as if we have some form of borer. Let's cut this and see. See that? Yes, it has some form of amaranth pest boring through the stem of the plant. So I guess that is why these ones down here are not doing so well. I see the same thing over here. So I'm not expecting anything from these that are in this garden here. So I'm just gonna cut these down. The ones that are good I will consume, and the rest I will just feed to the worms. want to encourage new growth, which is why I'm cutting these down, because they have gotten old. They're too hard to eat. But if I cut them down, at least it will start sprouting anew. I also am going to harvest some thyme. Mint is flowering. Oh, the thyme smells so good. And this is my lemon balm. The creatures are eating it down. Gonna harvest this scallion. All of these scallions have been harvested before and has regrown. I haven't harvested any of those ones over there yet, but this year I'm not quite satisfied with how they look because of the pests. They're not nice and lusciously green, they are spotted. But anyway, they're still going into the kitchen. So if you enjoyed this video and you would like to see more updates on what's happening in my garden, please give me a thumbs up. You can leave a comment in the section below. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe and turn on your notification for more updates like these. Thank you so much for watching and have yourself a wonderful day. Yeah, man. Time for growth.